All right, back here on Inside Wrestling Radio. And like I said, this is a special edition show. We do these every so often when we don't have a guest. And we'll bring Thomas in to let us know what he's been doing and what he's got coming up.
Are you saying Thomas not a guest anymore?
No, he's not a guest anymore. He's pretty much third mic now. He's part of the show, and we're glad to have him. You know, Thomas has got a lot of contacts in the business and knows everybody and pretty much everything.
Thank you.
And
I don't know about knowing everything, but I do know just about everybody.
Well, we appreciate you. We do appreciate you coming down and helping us out here with the show. And you got some things coming up that you're going to be helping us with in the future also as far as some guests and stuff. Is that correct?
Oh, yes. And let me just talk about what all I got going on. First off, tonight.
Tonight.
In Newberry, South Carolina. Okay. It's a Triangle Daycare that's 30 Boundary Street Extension, Newberry, South Carolina, 29108, for those of you that have GPSs and TomToms and stuff. SCW is running a benefit show for
St. Matthew's Baptist Church.
St. Matthew's Baptist Church there at the Triangle Daycare. What time is the show starting, Charlie?
Show will be starting at 8 o'clock.
8 o'clock. And boy, we have an exciting card on hand.
Fantastic. Tell us about it.
All right. We've got the SCW Heavyweight Champion Sinister Amp would be defending against Stoney Hooker, the man that he won the title from in the tournament a few weeks ago there in Lawrence. The SCW Tag Team Champions, the Raging Bull Manny Fernandez and Derek Free, will be defending against Deion Johnson and Newberry's own Black Angel.
Oh, that'll be a great match.
It will be a great match. Bubba Hogg will be defending the SCW United States title against Big Daddy Z. And they had a little, Big Daddy Z was a big fan favorite, and then he started to have a little trouble with Bubba. He wants the gold. So they had a little tag match there in Lawrence a few weeks ago, and Big Daddy Z turned on Bubba. And so Bubba's going for revenge tonight against him and defending his title. And we've got some more great matches, so who knows what else is going to happen. You never know what kind of surprise you'll see at SCW. How much are tickets, Charlie?
Tickets are $10 for that event.
$10 tickets are $10 the day of the event. So we got that going on this Friday, Saturday night. Now
that's tonight.
That's tonight. Yeah. That's right. And then now next Friday.
Okay.
I'm going to be, and next weekend, I'm going to be at the big fan fest there in Charlotte.
Oh, really?
Rick Price's Legends, NWA Legends Fan Fest.
Oh, really?
And I think what I'm going to do, since it'll be about noon-ish on Saturday when we have the show here, since we do it live, I'm going to call in. I'm going to call in from the fan fest, walking around.
You don't want to break kayfabe on the show.
Yeah, I know. I ain't breaking kayfabe. I ain't breaking kayfabe, son.
All right, go ahead.
So I'm going to do the fan fest. I'm going to call in from the fan fest live.
Oh, fantastic.
And just go around and talk trash to people and see some old friends and stuff. Go by. Talk with a high spots table and everything, and then go around.
Oh, that'll be great. We'll actually do that in lieu of the interview next week. We'll call Thomas there at the Fan Fest, and then he's just going to go around, like he said, and just talk to some people. And I think it'll be funny. I think it'll be interesting, and just let him go around and kind of harass some of the people there at the Fan Fest.
Right, and then I will probably end up to interview with me and Baby Doll at the bar.
Oh, that'd be great.
That's usually where I end up at the Fan Fest anyway. So it'll be a good deal. So we got that on hand for next week. And so interviews, we were talking to people about some interviews. I did that Legends, that K&S WrestleFest up in New Jersey the other week.
Yeah.
We started doing a on-the-road DVD with me, Manny, and ECW's Axel Rotten.
Oh, okay, cool.
That's going to be interesting.
And it's going to be interesting. Let's just say that we went to this wrestling show there in Union City, New Jersey. Then we came back to the hotel, and there was a nice little bar across the street, and we ended up at the bar. And the cops, let's just say the cops were called.
Oh, my goodness.
By the end of it, because one of Axel's buddies decided to be a Rock'em Sock'em Robot. You remember Rock'em Sock'em Robot?
Sure. Yeah.
On a guy there at the bar.
Oh, wow.
And they even called the ambulance for the guy.
You're kidding.
Although he was, nothing was wrong with him, other than the fact that he was just intoxicated.
A little inebriated.
Yeah. So, yeah, we've got that going on. So I'm trying to get Axel Rotten in here. I've also, October 22nd, not sure of exactly where the show is going to take place, but I have booked Brian Danielson versus Stoney Hooker.
No, is that right?
That is right. So I don't know exactly where it will be, but I'm looking forward to that. I'm not doing a lot of wrestling this fall. I'm working on my doctorate. So most of the wrestling I'm going to do is at SCW.
Oh, okay.
So I will mostly be at SCW this fall, but I am going to make a shot at doing one one show, helping out some, working with some friends and stuff. Also going on, connected with the stuff with Axel and Manny and stuff, I'm doing the little road trip stuff is done through TitleMatchWrestling.com.
Okay.
Telly Business is doing stuff. And Telly and I are working on a DVD set, The History of Omega.
Oh, really?
Now, we've done the Omega Uncommon Passion DVD.
Yeah, I was about to say, you already have a DVD out.
Yeah, and that was more just looking at the people involved in Omega rather than the history of the titles. And as I've talked to fans at wrestling shows and at the fan fest and stuff that recognize me from Omega and from the Hardy show,
sure.
They have said, well, you know, the DVD was good, but we would like to see one that's kind of the history of the matches, the history of the feuds, and the history of the promotion, really from 97, July of 97 when we started, through, I guess the last time we were all together was January of 99.
Okay.
So we're going to do a DVD of that time period, looking at the feuds, thoughts behind the booking, and that kind of stuff. So this is going to have some of the old guys that there and...
So you're going to actually be a behind-the-scenes type deal, and it will also be matches and
yeah,
all
it'll be the matches. It'll be the matches.
Oh, okay.
The things that people have never, ever seen, but we've never put on DVD.
Oh, that'll be cool. Yep. Yeah, that'll be great. Now, will Matt be a part of this DVD? Or?
Matt will not be a part of it. I'm not sure who all will be a part of it.
Okay.
Matt won't be, although we do have some old footage that we taped years ago for the Uncommon Passion DVD.
Yeah.
Where he talks about the booking and stuff that has not been released.
Oh, okay.
And we will put that on.
So you mean there's actual footage of Matt Hardy that Vince doesn't own?
There is footage of Matt Hardy doesn't own. That little 3-month period when he was kind of sort of released.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
In 2005.
So, yeah. And I tell you what, if we ever can work it out to where we can get Matt on the Inside Wrestling Radio show here, I'd really love him to
I'm
tell.
I'm working on it. I'm working on it.
Well, I know you are. I know you are. And I'd love for him to tell that story because I think that's still fresh in a lot of people's minds and fresh in his mind. And I would just like to get, you know, his uncensored, if you will, take on it and see, you know, exactly what he has to say about that deal. And if there's still any wounds behind that thing and you know, just kind of get his take on the whole story. So what else you got coming up, Thomas? Anything else to plug there?
That's really, other than I'm going to Florida on the 27th and 28th of August to help my friend Brandon Jessup, who actually is one of Shannon Moore's old wrestling trainees. He is trying to work his way up through the MMA ranks. He's done a number of amateur shows in Michigan this summer.
Right.
And he's got a tryout with XFC in Tampa. And I think they're working on getting some kind of deal with one of the networks.
Oh, very cool. And I want to talk to you some more about the MMA stuff. We're going to hopefully be able to get a couple of MMA guys in here in the future on the show. And, you know, kind of, I understand you're working something with some MMA stuff coming up, and you know some of those guys. And and we'll talk about that a little bit more and pick it up there when we come back from the break. And you're on Facebook. Tell everybody your Facebook page again.
It's just Thomas Simpson, one word. Thomas Simpson, though, on Facebook.
All right. Be sure to check that out. And we'll be right back with more with Thomas Simpson. We'll talk about some of the MMA stuff. And you also mentioned during the break there, Thomas, something about something going on in Canada.
Oh, yeah. That's with the Danielson show. I may put that on TV in Canada.
Oh, very cool.
On the Fight Network.
All right. We'll talk about that when we get back. More Inside Wrestling Radio coming right back at you.